Anyway, so in this video, it's all about Mi Router AX1800, and it's a product from Xiaomi. And as I promised you, I was going to do a configuration on this video. Sorry, a configuration on this device, and then show you exactly how it works. We'll also be going through its features, like the fully supports Wi-Fi 6 features, Qualcomm 5-core processor, okay? Supports mesh network as well. So this is all about this device. So please relax whilst I plug this device and then we get going with its configurations, okay? So please hold on. So it's powered on and it's working. Okay. So let's quickly delve into its configurations and see exactly how it works. Oh, good. It has even opened an automatic interface for me to start with its configuration. So let me quickly delve into it and then start configuring it. Okay, let me open it up. Yeah. Okay, so, you know, unlike usual routers where you would have to actually type in its default IP address and then be able to log in into the device and start with your configurations, I think this is a bit different. The moment I plugged in the device and connected with my network cable, it was able to give me a pop-up page. And this is the pop-up page we are currently on. So please, let's continue with the... it has given me another pop-up page. So let's continue with the configuration. So first of all, and actually this is my first time of touching this device. This is my first time of going through such device like this. So we need to first select our country of origin. So select your country or region of use, okay? So I need to click here. I'm using it. I don't know if I can. Okay, let me just use US. Okay. Why is it that I cannot see US here? Okay, let me simply use United Kingdom. Okay. So I've choose United Kingdom next. I've read and agreed with the user agreement and privacy. So try now. Okay. Okay. Internet guide, testing your network. Current mode has been detected as set to retrieve IP automatically. DHCP. Click next to continue. Okay, so automatically it's on DHCP mode. So we need to click next. So Wi-Fi settings. This is the Wi-Fi name it has provided by default. This is what we are seeing, okay? We can give it a customized name. I mean a customized Wi-Fi name, okay? And then here we can assign a password to it. So I want to assign this password. So password at 123. So this is the password I've assigned to this particular device, okay? Next. Internet guide. So setup complete, Wi-Fi restarting, reconnect to Wi-Fi to access the internet. Okay. So at this point, it is recommended to save a screenshot of your Wi-Fi password below. Okay, so this is simply what it's saying. And it is giving us the different dual bands. That's the 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz. Okay. And these are its various passwords. And this is the default, its default IP address. Okay. So the next thing, I need to take out this repeater and then plug it onto a switch, let's say in my office or home. I'm currently taking it down. Okay, so I've taken it out and I'm going to plug it into a switch. Okay, let me see if the Wi-Fi is up for connection. Okay, it's up for connection. So let me try and log in and see if it's going to permit me in. So password at 123. Confirmed. Okay, so I have the repeater here. Wow. Okay, connected. Let me check on my IP and then see. IP config 3.3.1. So 192.3.1.3. Okay. I don't get something. Do I need to install an application? Okay, great. So it's asking me to actually download a My Wi-Fi app to manage a router. So that is what it's currently telling me. Okay, bingo. So on a web interface, these are the informations we are able to get. Okay, so it's able to differentiate between the two dual bands, the 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz. And it's able to tell us the number of connected hosts onto these bands. Okay, so I'm currently connected onto the 5 gigahertz band. And so this is me. This is the router, the firmware, the system version, sorry, the MAC address, the SN. And this is internet, but we don't currently have internet source, so it will be difficult to get connection from here. And we have about two devices connected to it. If you click on it, you're able to see details of that connected devices. That is the IP address and the MAC address as well. Okay. If we go to its settings, okay. So at the settings here, Wi-Fi settings, we see Smart Connect. So under Smart Connect, it says when the feature is on 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz, networks will share a name. The router will choose the best available signal. For example, it will switch to 5 gigahertz network if the device is close, and to 2.4 gigahertz network if it's far away. Brief interruptions may occur during the switch. As simple as that. Now, under the 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi band, you can actually do a customized change of name, you can change the kind of Wi-Fi security encryption. You can change the password. You can change the wireless channel, the bandwidth, and the signal strength. Okay. The same way you can do same thing to the 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi as well. Now, this is what it says. There is another tab here, which is Wi-Fi 5 8.2.11 AC compatible mode. So this is a type of Wi-Fi protocol that certain devices support. So if you enable this feature, those devices can be able to connect to this device. Else you leave it at default. So it says some legacy devices do not support Wi-Fi 6 well and may have compatibility issues such as scan failure or Wi-Fi connection failure. After this switch is turned on, the router will run in Wi-Fi 5 mode, compatible mode, to resolve the compatibility issues. It will also turn off Wi-Fi 6 related functions such as OFDA, OFDMA, BSS coloring, etc. So if this feature is enabled, it's going to turn off certain features that comes with Wi-Fi 6. Okay, but we don't want anything to do with that, so we leave it at default. We have MU MIMO, need clients support this feature to enhance Wi-Fi experience. Okay. So this is it with the Wi-Fi settings, which is very brief. Okay. Now, if we come to the network settings. Under network settings, it's on DHCP mode. Else, you can decide to change it to PPPoE. You can change it to static IP address. That is if you know credentials of this internet coming in. Okay, else you leave it on DHCP so that it automatically picks any IP that comes with the internet. You can decide to configure DNS automatically, or you can do it manually. Okay, so in case I can decide to give this particular DNS to it. Okay, I can decide to apply this particular DNS to the configuration I'm doing. Okay. It assigned me up. So it's going to log me back in. And I'll be able to continue with whatever I'm doing. But I don't want this DNS. I want the gateway to give me an automatic DNS. Okay. So I set it on configure DNS automatically. I guess it's going to log me out and then bring me back on this page again. So let's wait for some seconds. Okay, so it's back, right? Now, this is the one port speed. This has got to do with the speed that is coming in from outside, as in the internet or your gateway. The speed that is coming in from your internet into the router. So it says one port speed. Here it has stated that it's on automatic, and that's the recommended. That's the recommendation. Okay, or recommended speed. Reason being that you wouldn't know which kind of speed you are getting from a particular network. So when you set it on automatic, between 1000 m. And then 100 m. Negotiations is going to be between these two speed, right? It's going to be between these two speed. Else, if you choose one, let's say 1000 m, and the internet you are getting is not to that amount, you know, it's going to kind of create a lot of confusion. So it's good to always leave it on auto. MAC address clone. So this is the current MAC address. It says you can change MAC addresses for this device manually. Whoa, this is one of the things I like. This is a kind of, you know, most of these network security and prevention styles, we mostly deal with MAC addresses and IP addresses. But so often, it is hard to bypass using your MAC address. So if you have a device that enables you to be able to change your MAC address, you know, it makes your work simple and you can always bypass those measures. That's if those security measures are that weak and not strong. Okay. We have the switch modes. Switch between router mode and repeater mode. Simple. You can change this device into repeater mode or just to the router mode. Okay, repeater meaning repeating other signals that it picks up. But this is the main router and we have the repeater here. So we are going to replicate the repeating on this device and see how it works. Okay. Alright, so it says security. Alright, security. So wireless access control. Control mode, block place mode. Okay, so meaning you can actually block certain devices from they could see your signal alright, but they cannot be able to connect to this Wi-Fi and start using its internet. So this is where you do that. Okay. Let's go to the next tab, which is the LAN settings. So this is where you actually configure your DHCP server and then change your LAN IP as well. If we click here, we're able to see the status of the device. Add mesh. Okay, this is where you can add the mesh mode. So you say add a mesh mode node. Put the mesh node you are adding near to the central access point. The node should be no more than 3 meters away from the central access point. Power on the node and wait for the router system indicator to turn blue. Okay. So searching mesh nodes. I'm trying to search if there is any mesh node around. Okay. Okay. There is none around. So this is it with this. But we are not done yet. The next thing is let me try and connect to the repeater to see if it recognizes it. Okay. So I'm currently going to connect to its repeater. So this is the repeater. Extends the router signal. Okay. Okay, so with respect to the Wi-Fi extender, you need to actually download its application on your mobile phone and then you can be able to manage it from there. I think it has a QR code here that enables you to actually use it.